The future is electric, and well, it's inevitable, so it's time to face it head on. In this video, we'll be installing this Lectron charging station. We'll talk pros and cons, see what comes in the box, check out its features, and talk about why you want to future-proof your garage for electric cars now. Also, this is a great upgrade for my BMW i3. Look how cool it looks too. All right, so let's check out this Lectron charging station a little bit closer, see what comes in the box and how easy it is to install. So just looking at the box here, we can see what the design's gonna be like. We can see that this is the 48 amp EV charging station. So that's pretty ridiculous. That's a lot of amperage. So you do have to make sure you have the NEMA plug 1450 available, you know, either installed in your garage or something that you can install in the future, because you will need it in order to make this work. You also have the J-hook included, so you can plug in the charging cord. And obviously that charging cord is compatible with the J1772 standard that most cars use in America, except for the Tesla. It has the extra long 20-foot cable, and then yeah, kind of mentions the same thing as before. A little bit more information on here. So it's for 200 to 240 volts, operating temperature between negative 22 Fahrenheit to 122, so it can be installed outside. And we have what comes in the box right here. But anyway, let's open it up and actually take a closer look at it. So of course you get your manual, looks to be really well written and a lot of illustrations, so that's easy to follow. As you can see, it tells you how to remove the bracket from the device, how to properly mount it on the wall, and how to mount your hook for the charging cable and everything else. And it even tells you how to hardwire it into a breaker panel, basically. Of course, that has to be done by a qualified electrician and everything else. And a little bit of specifications here in the back. They do give you a little paper that shows how to, like, reference paper and how to, where to drill the holes to mount it on the wall. Pretty cool, I'm gonna be using that. You also get the holder for the actual charging plug and the corresponding hardware for it. Very good. And obviously you get the J-hook as well, so you can mount that on the wall for easy storage of the cable. And then of course there is the unit itself. As you can see, it's not too big by itself. The actual unit's pretty decent size. And if we turn around, here is that metal plate you're going to be mounting to the wall. You have to loosen these screws on each side. There's four of them. Pull this out, put that on the wall, and then, you know, install the actual device on it, and then tighten the screws on the side. So easy enough. And as you can see, this unit means business. This is some thick, thick cable. Think of it as, you know, the cables that you see in actual charging stations. That's how thick it is. And if you look on the cable itself, you can see that it has two 7-gauge wires in it, plus a 9-gauge. So it's going to be your two power wires and one for neutral or whatever it's called. I'm not an electrician, don't quote me on that stuff. But yeah, it looks very solid. I do like that a lot. So one of those cables, of course, goes to this NEMA 1450 plug. As you can see, it's one of these massive ones, something you probably see in your dryer at home and things like that. But yeah, make sure you have one of these plugs installed in your garage before you try to use this. And then the other end, so the longer cable, 20 feet, is your actual charger. So the actual plug that plugs into your car. Looks pretty good here. So everything seems to be very high quality. So I'm very excited to get this installed. There is not that much more to show you on here, but basically there is a power button on this side that turns the unit on or off. We're gonna have a little display here to show us some information. And well, that's basically it. Elegant and should be really good. So let's go ahead and get this installed. What makes this a very easy DIY is that installing this charging station is as simple as hanging a picture on a wall. I used the included tracing paper to mark where I want to drill the holes, installed the anchors, and then screwed the mounting plate with the included screws. Of course, you have to have a 220 volt electrical plug already wired up in your garage to plug this unit in. If you want to charge at the highest rate of 48 amps, you will have to have a NEMA 1450 outlet installed with proper gauge wire and breakers, of course. This is quickly becoming the standard for EV charging, and most new homes have it in the garage already pre-wired. However, if you live in an older house like I do, have an electrician check out the circuit to make sure it's all safe. I'm glad I did, as my 220 volt plug is only set up for 30 amps. This is of course slower than what this charging station can do, but I will be upgrading the wiring very soon to take full advantage of the power this can deliver. Luckily, Lectron has thought of this and has settings on the back of the unit where you can limit the current it will draw. This will keep me safe while I wait for the electrical work to be done. The setting allows you to choose between 16, 24, 32, 40, and 48 amps, which is very convenient, especially because you can hardwire this unit in and run custom wiring to the unit. So you want to make sure it's safe for the wiring you have this connected to. So as you can see, this unit has many pros, and of course using this charging station couldn't be easier. Just power it on with the button on the right side and plug it into the car like you would any other charger. This is of course compatible with all J1772 electric vehicles, which is pretty much all new EVs other than Tesla. If you do have a Tesla, Lectron sells an adapter for your car as well. They can be used with this unit. Obviously, I have installed this unit inside my garage, but it can be installed outside as well, as it is IP55 rated, which makes it weather resistant. Now, why did I decide to upgrade from my standard charger to this charging station? Well, it's all about setting up my garage for the future. While my BMW i3 has a small battery and doesn't take very long to charge, a modern EV with a decent range has a huge battery and takes days to charge at level 1 or a portable level 2 chargers. My wife has been thinking about getting a plug-in hybrid or an EV, so it was time to future-proof my garage. It's also nice to let your friends charge up while they're visiting you. Compared to my portable charger, this can charge 3 times as fast. Has a very clean and attractive interface and design, and looks very sleek without wires all over the floor. Another reason I wanted to upgrade was the lack of information I was getting from either the charger or the car about what was actually happening. The best this BMW i3 can do is show you when it will be done charging, but nothing about how much electricity is being used. With the Lectron V-Box, I have a clear indication of the rate of charge and how many kilowatts was used during the last charge. The only feature missing that would have been useful is smart functionality. Unfortunately, there is no Wi-Fi or phone connectivity, so you can't check the status remotely or set a timer or schedule. This is, of course, clearly stated when you buy the unit, but I thought I'd mention it. Another thing to consider before buying is the installation of the NEMA 1450 outlet, which can be expensive, but without proper wiring, you can't reach the speeds that this offers. Overall, there is a lot of value in this Lectron V-Box. At 220 volts, you can charge at around 11.5 kilowatt hours, which is about 45 miles every hour added to your range, and also 9 times faster than a standard 110 volt socket. As always, I have linked this product down below if you'd like to purchase one, and if you'd like to learn 10 things you didn't know about this BMW i3, click on the video that just popped up right here.